So we had established through other experiments that migrating primordium requires a receptor at the rear that acts as a vacuum cleaner to locally reduce the guidance molecule to suck it up and therefore to generate a directional cue. Here we can see a mutant tissue that lacks this vacuum cleaner receptor. It's labeled in red, and normally this migrating tissue will not move due to the absence of this vacuum cleaner at the rear. However, the expression of the vacuum cleaner receptor within the nerve now drives a new type of migration. Here, the primordium's behavior is dependent on the position of the nerve because the nerve is providing the vacuum cleaner. Now, what we find in this particular case is when the nerve goes too far forward and actually comes through the tissue, it has some degree of freedom, you'll find that the tissue's movement arrests because now the vacuum cleaner has turned too far ahead of the tissue, we think. However, when the nerve then falls back, we can see that the migration of the tissue is much more efficient. And that's because now we think the vacuum cleaner molecule is in a position that's appropriate to generate this path.